Hi friends, welcome to the new series Angular Interview Concepts with Explanation. In this series, I'm explaining some of the concepts those are most focused on Angular interviews. If you just prepare for your Angular interview, like a question and answer format, it won't help you a lot. If the same question is asked differently, you may struggle. Instead, if you understand the core concept behind that, you will not forget forever and you can easily answer. That is what I'm trying to explain with some examples. Let's start. In this video, I'm going to explain the difference between value and ngValue in Angular. I have created an Angular application. In app component, I have a container div. Inside that, I have a top and a bottom div. In the top div, I'm having a dropdown in which I have two options, accept and decline. For accept, I have given the value as true, and for decline, I have given the value as false. And I'm using ng model to bind these two value to a variable called selected value. And then if the selected value is true, I'm showing this text, and if it is false, I'm showing this text. And in the bottom div, again, I have a dropdown, but this time instead of hard coding, I'm having a students array in TypeScript component, and I'm using ng for to loop through the students array and showing the students inside the dropdown. Here I am binding the student ID to the value, and I am binding selected student using ng model. Okay, let's preview. Here, initially it is showing you have not accepted. When I choose accept, we can see it is changed to you have accepted. But if I choose decline, it is still showing you have accepted. Why is that? The reason is when we use value, it always gives a string. Even though we bind it with a number or a boolean, it will be considered as string. That is why boolean logic is not working here. If I change value to ngValue, it will work. Let me show that. So this is the difference. Let me explain using another example. Here, when I select a student, we can see it is showing the student ID. This does not make any sense to the end user. So instead of student ID, it will be good if you show the name. Now we can see the name, but to fetch the student details from database, we may need the student ID, but now we have only the name. So instead of binding to student name, let's bind it to the student object itself so that we can show the name in the front end and use the ID in the back end. When I select, it is showing nothing because when we use value, this object will be converted to a string. Let me use a change event and show that. You can see it is not an object, it is a string, and so it does not have an ID or a name property. Here also, instead of value, we can use ngValue. Now we can see when I select a student, we can see the student name in the front end, and we can use the student ID in the back end. Hope you understood the difference now. Please subscribe to my channel and support me. I'll be back with another concept soon. Thank you. Bye.